Good afternoon, good evening, actually. How are you doing, my friends? Anna is here and this is Daily Juice. I wanted to hop on. It's Friday evening. I hope you had a fantastic week and you are doing something fun, either eating dinner or having a happy hour. Let me know when you hop on here, say hello. So here's what I want to talk to you about today for just a quick moment. I am talking about your finances and your body, right? A couple of weeks ago, actually last month, and on our money date 2 weeks ago, we discussed a couple of things that just play into our overall well-being, right? Because finances not only have to deal with numbers, it has to deal with how you feel about yourself, how you look, right? And how you behave. Hi, David. Thanks for joining. So I'm talking about how stress, right? And we hear this a lot, how stress affects our physical and mental performance, but we're not really talking quite a bit about how unhealthy lifestyle, such as not exercising regularly, having a poor diet, right? Not getting enough sleep affects and has a connection to our finances. Have you even thought about that? And, you know, I kind of go in these phases, right? And today I'm kind of focusing on exercise portion of it. But I do go in phases where I may not be getting a regular exercise. And I notice that there are changes, right? And I notice that there are changes in how I, you know, sort of go through my day or kind of mood I have. Hi, Debbie. Thanks for joining. So, and I kind of looked into this because there is a huge connection, right? And let me give you a couple of examples, like some of the most obvious ones. So let's say you're a smoker, right? And think about this. Not only are you spending money on cigarettes, right? Or if you indulge in other kinds of drugs, right? Recreational drugs or alcohol. Not only are you spending money on that, which is probably okay, right? I can understand that. You got to enjoy life as well. But think about down the road, what happens to your body and what kind of effects can it have on your future medical costs? So that's example number one. What if you're not eating healthy, right? What kind of effect does that have on your overall spending? Number one, now, today, and then into the future, right? Healthcare costs are gonna go up. So I want you to think about how unhealthy lifestyle habits, and particularly not exercising, affects the overall picture, not just today, but down the road. And the older we get, the more, you know, the more difficult it is, right? Because everything is changing, including our body. So I wanted to kind of pause this question today for you to think about it. But I mean, I know that everybody has, or most of us have this love. Hi, Wanda. Thanks for hopping on. I hope you're having a great Friday evening. Most of us have this, what I call love-hate relationship with exercise, right? But even last week when we talked about on our money date episode, we talked about habits of rich individuals, right? And exercise is being one of those habits. And so I constantly kind of think about that. And I have to get my fair share of exercise. Otherwise, I don't feel 100%. So, you know, that's the point of today's discussion. If you want to stay young, if you want to stay sharp, agile, if you want to be energized, get that in. I'm not the exercise coach or professional here at all. That's not what I do. But I know and I see even in my own life how that affects and changes what I do, what I think, and how I respond to environment and people around me. So that's my point, right? And think about those unhealthy habits as well, because most likely that's going to help you cut down the cost somewhere and redirect it probably in a good direction. Like one of the examples that I have sort of for my, you know, from the experience with clients is a lot of times those unhealthy habits lead to spending more money, for example, on life insurance, right? If you're a smoker, for example, the premiums are 3 times more in cost versus somebody who is a non-smoker. For older clients, right, when you're applying for example, long-term care insurance, and I see this quite a bit as well, costs are more, right? Because they're looking at your overall health, and if all of those things are there, think about, you know, what that does to your overall financial well-being. So that's my 2 minute. I usually, you know, when I started this Daily Juice idea, I really wanted only to talk for 2 minutes, but I'm enjoying it and I love that you guys coming on, so it turns out to be a little longer, but I hope you are getting good knowledge and getting good benefits. So that's all I've got for today. Thanks so much for hopping on. I'm off to have some dinner and relax for the rest of the night, and have a good weekend, and I'll see you tomorrow.